Hello, welcome to Lenze Training. This tutorial shows how to add a i700 drive to a project and how to configure it. In this example, a project named PLC Base Motion PRG is opened. The controller 3200C serves as PLC device. In order to add the i700 drive to the project, right-click on EtherCAT Master and select Scan for Devices. A window with all scanned devices is opened. Press the Copy All Devices to Project button to copy the list of devices to your project. The changes can be found under EtherCAT Master. These drives can also be added manually during offline configuration. In order to add the i700 drive in offline mode, right-click on EtherCAT Master and select Add Device. Browse the devices from the device list and select the desired device. Press the Add Device button to add the selected device under EtherCAT Master. Press the Close button to close the Add Device window. Right-click on the single inverter and select Properties. Name it Drive 2 and press the OK button. Again, right-click on the single inverter and select Edit Object to open the device settings. Here, Diagnosis, Signal Flow, Motor Commissioning, Parameter Settings, Oscilloscope and Firmware information can be found. Go to the Motor Commissioning tab. Press the Select Motor button. Enter the C86 code value from the motor nameplate, for example, 1311. On the right side, some of the motor nameplate data are shown. Press the OK button to accept the motor data. Press the Close button after completion of the automatic motor data parameterization. Go to the Parameter List tab and then select Holding Brake under the Motor or Feedback or Brake tab. By default, the value of the Brake Operating Mode parameter is 1, meaning the brake logic functionality within the controller application. In this mode, brake control is processed by the controller via control word. This mode provides torque pre-control, which prevents active loads from sagging, like in hoist applications. It considers the delay time of the holding brake during the opening and closing process via controller application. Change this parameter to mode 0, which has reduced brake logic functionality. This teach wear case is free from any active load, so there may be a different behavior in your case. Mode 0 means that the holding brake is controlled by the drive via state machine. There is no torque pre-control to take over the load when releasing the brake. Keep in mind that the holding brake is an important element of the safety concept of the entire machine. Therefore, be particularly careful when commissioning this system part. Go to DC voltage under the Monitoring tab. As the i700 teach wear case has a 230-volt single-phase supply, set the mains voltage to 230 volts. Set the undervoltage warning threshold to 230 volts as well. It may change according to the input supply voltage. Press the Save button and close the tab. Please name the double inverter drive 1 and configure it correctly by following the same procedure as for drive 2. As opposed to drive 2, double inverter drive 1 has two parameter sets for both channels. Right-click on drive 1 and select Edit Object to open the device settings. Under Motor Commissioning, there are separate tabs for setting the motor data. For example, Motor A and Motor B. Under Parameter List, there are three sections. One is for shared settings, one for axis A, and one for axis B in order to configure the two channels separately. Go to the Online tab and select Login, then confirm the warning message to download the project. Go to Debug tab and select Start to enable the controller. Select Save Parameter Sets under the Online tab to save the parameters in the drive. Diagnosis of the drive is possible in online mode. Go to Device Settings of Drive 2 and choose Diagnosis. You can monitor the actual values of DC bus voltage, position, velocity, torque, and current. You can also monitor the drive status word, fault, and warning indications, as well as error codes and error descriptions. The LEDs allow fast diagnostics. Soft keys are available to reset access errors, show the internal logbook, and to show the status of digital IOs. This will help you detecting errors and doing service. Furthermore, there is a graphical representation of position, speed, and torque controller under the Signal Flow tab. If required, you can optimize the PID speed controller for fine-tuning the axis. Select Log Out and save the project on your local drive.